Today I'm going to do a requested tutorial, and it was requested by, I think her username is Kaha2020. I think that's how you say it, either Kaha or Kaja2020. I think it's Kaha. Anyway, she has asked for an appropriate makeup to school look. She doesn't want it to be a very heavy makeup to school. What I've done is I have incorporated three kinds of looks with different lip colors. I don't think this is the lip combo that she wants. But in the video, I've already tested out a few looks. I think there are three altogether. It ranges from a nude kind of lips to a slightly medium kind of lips, and then also this one. It is a very friendly makeup tutorial whereby, in terms of friendly, which means that the eyes are very neutral, the cheeks are very neutral, so you can play up with your lips. You can use this as a base. If you want, you can try out any other colors if you want. Yeah, you can do whatever it is, but just keep your eye makeup very light, and then your lip combinations can be either a nude color or a slightly a glossy lips kind of color and such. So have fun with this tutorial. Let me know, Kaha2020. Let me see, what's her name? Her name is Shaza. So, Shaza, let me know what, among the three looks, which one would you prefer? And those who are watching as well, which lip combination would you prefer? Let me know. This is an appropriate makeup look for school, as well as if you are going for an interview, or it's an appropriate look for to go to the office. If you are not that familiar with the school system in Malaysia, we don't wear makeup to school. We cannot wear makeup to school. Well, that was when I was in school and they did not allow that. But I think they do implement it until now, because my sister, you know, she's not going to school with makeup on. We just apply moisturizer as well as a little bit of a loose powder, or maybe just baby powder on the face. Yeah, we're very simple at that. So it's a little bit easy on us. We just need to get up, get in the shower, and then have breakfast and leave for school. Yeah, it's pretty simple life, but pretty hectic at it. Anyway, I hope that you've enjoyed this tutorial. Like I said, if you like any of the combinations that I have used, please let me know which one are those. And then if you find it helpful, let me know. If you have any question, yes, let me know as well. Take care, and I'll see you guys very soon. Bye!
Let's start from the very beginning. Okay, who remembers where that song was from? Please leave in the comments below which movie do you think it was. I'm taking a fluffy blending brush to apply my concealer. I do have quite a bit of blemishes to hide this time. Apply it on your blemishes first, and then later on blend out the edges only. If I'm not mistaken, this song that you're listening right now is from the movie Never Been Kissed, starring Drew Barrymore. Do you guys remember that movie? Now I'm taking my erase paste in number 2 medium, and I'm going to apply this just a little bit underneath my eyes. Just apply it a little bit at a time, just to conceal the dark circles underneath your eyes. If you think that it's a little bit harder to apply concealer underneath your eyes, look up into the mirror and you have more eye space in order to work on. After this, I'm going to apply my foundation in Soft Touch Mousse Makeup from Essence. Using a foundation brush, I'm going to apply this all over my face, including underneath my eyes where I've applied the erase paste. Applying your foundation on top of your concealer blends the concealer really well. Even if you don't want to use an eye primer, just apply the foundation on top of your lids too. This is a very easy makeup. It doesn't take you too long in the morning in order to apply it on. To get that glowy flush to your cheeks, you need to apply a cream blush. Here I'm using a Can Make cream blush in number 7, I think it's number 7. I'm still using the same foundation brush because it blends it a little bit easier since there's still a little bit of the foundation left on the brush. Apply a little bit of the blush on your nose, chin, and forehead area. To make the cream blush last, I'm going to apply this loose powder from Silky Girl with a fluffy brush, and I'm going to apply this all over my skin. This application makes the blush look softer. Next, I'm going to reapply my cream blush just a tiny bit, just to enhance my cheeks. Now the blush doesn't look as harsh. I'm going to start my eye makeup next. Taking Urban Decay Primer Potion as my eye primer, I'm going to apply this all over my upper lids. Now, most of these makeups are available at the Asian drugstores. I'm taking a Revlon Colorstay Mineral Eyeshadow in Tiger Eye. I'm taking the lightest champagne color and applying this all over my upper lids. I'm really trying to keep this look really simple, but you can skip the eye makeup if you want to. Just apply blush as well as your lipstick if you want. Now this is a Maybelline eyeliner in brown. Not quite sure what the exact name is. Anyway, I'm applying this a little bit thick on the upper lash line as well as just a little bit on the waterline. Now I'm taking the Rimmel Soft Kohl Kajal Eye Pencil in Jet Black. I'm applying this eyeliner right into the roots of my eyelashes. This technique will make the eyelashes appear thicker. See what I mean? It's an illusion of thicker lashes. I'm going to curl my lashes as well as apply mascara. Now, if you're going to skip the eye makeup, just make sure to have mascara on, just to give a little bit of a definition to your eyes. You can just put on one foot if you want. Okay, first look. I'm going to take this lip conditioner in Plum Perfect from MAC. Depending on the look that you want, you can apply this as a stain or you can apply a second coat of it just to make the color a little bit deeper. See, it's a nice flush to the lips. Now this is just for fun. I'm going to apply a second coat of this lip conditioner just to let you see what it looks like. That's the first look. Let's get ready for the second look. I'm going to take this lipstick in Peachy Pink Nude Color from Rimmel in Have Fun, applying it directly on the lips from the tube. Giving shouts to these victims of wrongful death. Now, soon as we're rid of society, small terrors, the sooner these teenagers. This look would be much, much softer. See? It looks a little bit more seamless. So that was how look number 2 looks like. Now let's get ready for look number 3. Now this is a very good transition from day to night makeup, whereby I'm using this dark purple lipstick from Rimmel in Stare at Me. I love the color of this lipstick. It's a very nice deep purple red kind of color. I'm going to blot off my lipstick and then maybe either reapply it again if you want, or like what I'm doing is I'm going to apply that lip conditioner in Plum Perfect just to give a more glossy look. Now you can stop there if you want, but I'm going to apply this Stay Glossy lip gloss from Rimmel in Timeless Allure just to give it a little bit more of a purple color. Oh, I've just looked up the name of that eyeliner from Maybelline in brown, which is called Caramel. I hope that this has been helpful for you, Shaza, as well as everyone else. Take care, and I'll see you guys very soon. Bye!